From Hollywood comes the most exciting motion picture news of 1938. Walt Disney has completed and released his first full-length feature production, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, in Technicolor, the most daring adventure in screen entertainment since the birth of the motion picture. As its credit titles, longest in cinema history, flash across the nation's screens, audiences for the first time realize the tremendous amount of manpower required for the production of this epoch-making animated picture. The entirely new form of storytelling that already has captivated every man, woman, and child who has seen it. Just how was Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs created? And how are the famous Disney short films made? To give you the answer, we take you behind the closed doors of the famed Walt Disney Studio in Hollywood, doors usually barred to all visitors. During the past 3 years, the studio staff has grown from less than 300 to more than 700 artists and musicians. They worked in shifts, night and day, to complete this unique experiment in entertainment. Remember as a kid how you made your own movies by drawing little figures on the pages of a pad and flipping the pages to make the figures move? That's the basic principle behind animated pictures today. But that's not all there is to it. First, you need a story. Thinking up funny stories is the job of Walt Disney's writers, gag men, and sketch artists. After much trial and error, several hundred rough drawings illustrating the high points of each story are completed. Let's follow the story into conference, where Walt Disney and his hard-boiled directors look it over. Not a picture, long or short, goes into production without Walt's personal okay. Next, a director whips the script and dialogue into final form. Then he calls in his assistants, including his musical composer, and plans the score of the picture, timing out each scene carefully. He even acts out every move of the action, so that the men who work with him can visualize what the scene will look like on the screen. Now he sets his expert animators to work, the skilled artists who draw every movement in complete detail, just as you will see it in the theater. Each animator's drawing board is lighted from below. He looks through the paper at the character he has previously outlined and draws the next movement in correct position. This clever animator is using a mirror to capture a tricky facial expression like this. Let's move along to the test camera department. Here, the animator's rough drawings are photographed in sequence, one at a time. This film is developed and returned to the animator, who checks to see how good it is by running it in a small projection machine called a moviola. In this moviola, as the animator runs his film backward and forward, we catch a graceful glimpse of the screen's newest heroine, Snow White herself. Now we're in one of the studio projection rooms, where Walt and his staff study the rough animation of a sequence about the seven lovable little dwarfs. Once they are okayed, the thousands of pencil drawings go to the inking department. Here, hundreds of pretty girls, in a comfortable building all their own, well-lighted, air-conditioned throughout, cover the drawings with sheets of transparent celluloid. Then they painstakingly trace every line of every drawing in ink, following exactly in every detail the original animation drawings. Now the picture moves into its final stage, color. In the studio paint laboratory, all colors used are made up from secret formulas. Expert chemists develop more than 1,500 different shades of color for Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. The ink celluloids next go to the painting department, where more pretty girls apply the final colors on the back. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs require 250,000 celluloids painted like this one. In another department of the big Disney studio, artists delicately paint the beautiful stage settings for the picture. These backgrounds are done in watercolor. Artists work for months on backgrounds like the interior of the Seven Dwarfs' cottage. But the colossal task isn't finished even yet. The celluloids and backgrounds must still be photographed by the master camera in Technicolor. Here, the operator puts a Donald Duck celluloid on top of a background as the overhead camera exposes one frame of film. To photograph Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, this operation had to be repeated more than 500,000 times. Next, the film passes into the hands of technicians, and the sound effects are recorded. Finally, a symphony orchestra records the musical score, the hit tunes that will thrill listeners the world over. Now comes a crucial moment, the picture's world premiere in Hollywood. Crowds flock to see an animation exhibit set up outside the theater and to enjoy Dwarfland, a miniature village with real dwarfs. When the picture opens at the famed Carthay Circle Theater, every star and executive in the movie colony turns out to pay tribute to the genius of Walt Disney. Leo Spitz, president of RKO Radio Pictures, Mickey and Minnie Mouse, and Donald Duck, Bob Burns and the Seven Dwarfs, Shirley Temple, Marlena Dietrich and Doug Fairbanks Jr., Luella Parsons, famous movie critic, and Walt Disney himself to present to the world his greatest achievement. Next day, newspaper and magazine critics rave about Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, says the usually hard-boiled reviewer of Time magazine. More than 3 million paintings and drawings like these were created by Walt Disney and his staff of artists to complete this entertainment triumph at a cost of more than $1.5 million. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs broke every box office record at the Carthay Circle Theater. Audiences universally acclaim it as something entirely new in motion pictures. They love its new and amazing characters. Snow White, warm, human. They thrill to its love story, tender and romantic. They remember its music, its 8 big new song hits. They laugh uproariously at the most amusing characters Walt Disney has ever created, the Seven Little Dwarfs. But let Walt Disney tell you about them himself.
Dwarfs' names fit their personalities. This pompous-looking individual is Doc, the self-appointed leader of the group. And this little fellow is bashful. He's secretly in love with Snow White. And this funny face is Sneezy. He has hay fever. And old Droopy Eyes is called Sleepy. And Happy here with the beaming smile. And old Sourpuss here is Grumpy, the woman hater. And last but not least is Dopey. He's nice, but sort of silly.